Hey up, now then folks, you've tuned into Rydale Vintage Tractor Club's ploughing match, also known as Eric's Match, which claimed another international casualty this year, being Andrew Pashby's clutch, which just gave out. Last year it was our BWD6, it sheared off the attaching shackle for that hydraulics off the ram, which you can see in last year's video. We can see roughly around about 53 people participating, with a few more people just turning up for a look on the day. It's also where you'll see me and my brother going head to head in the same conventional class. So you'll have to put your bets on who's going to win. And a very nice atmosphere this plough match, with everybody helping out. Even the butty van when it got stuck towards the end of the day. In the next clip you'll see my dad turn up on his Field Marshal Series 3A, which sounds rather well after clearing its throat out on Kieran Wall's rack saw bench last year at the Yorkshire Steam Rally. It looks as though all the best ploughers do a bit of gardening when they're at the ploughing match as well.
It is, isn't it? Marvellous.
Yes.
Especially when sun's shining on a bit of red like this.
That's right, yes.
It was good to see mine and my brother's age related tractors were put together, a B450 and a B275, each with international ploughs on the back, is with a B13, mine with a B142. Good job I told John Wood to put his strap on for when he had his butterfingers. So what's the scores then, George Dawes? I just narrowly missed beating my brother by 5 points, so only managed to bag 5th place beneath Andrew's 4th. Looks like John Hall's disc has slipped.
I don't like to do some damage with that big adjustable.
So this is some of Andrew Pashby's remarkable ploughing before his clutch packed in sadly. And I was packed up against it at Rillerton Young Farmers ploughing match when Mick Harper came across and said, "Have you done that?" I was just a bit too slow to say yes I had. There was a bit of a mix-up in the Ferguson class, as first prize was given to A. Richardson in the Day Glow jacket to the left, but really it should have gone to Richard Mee to our right-hand side with the red boiler suit, and then second prize should have gone to Mush Berryman straight in front. Then B. Chapman got third, who's to the very left of our screen.
Yeah, just right for this job. As you say, Ladwick Fergie, he ought to be able to just go a bit faster.
He does, doesn't he? Just throw it again. Yeah, just throw it. I think yesterday you didn't want to be over slow. No. You just want to be on with it, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a literal, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like a 1.35 type.
Yeah.
So,
that's a good sound, mate.
I don't think I'd have pulled the 3.3 today with the 1.35.
Yeah.
I did clock in all day yesterday.
Yeah.
I've got amazed, but I can't
Which side's better? That side's better, is it?
Get power here if you want power, yeah.
I'll go around the...
I'll go push.
You're not bloody.
I'm going to go push.
You'll fall over and injure yourself and seriously injure your knee.
Aye.
Is it recording?
Hold on.
There's a big.
There's a
brake
bar. Yeah, there is. So here we have a proper tractor here parked up. Robert wish he could have one of these, but he never did. Now he's enjoying himself, ploughing a big deep furrow. He's loving it.
I can remember once letting somebody else change their plot at Rillerton Young Farmers ploughing match going back in the day when I was a member, and that caused hell on. And I can see why now after having a go at this ploughing match. How different the land was in different spots. Like here it's a bit harder, so it carved out a bit nicer to where I was. It was a bit fluffy and it just seemed to stick to plough no end.
I would run after him, but I'm too fat. I had too much beer last night. It's not ideal, like. He's always loved ploughing a big dirty furrow, as Robert. Nice and deep. He's absolutely in his element. Loving every minute. Not one tractor left in the field, everybody's gone home, gone to the pub. Here he is, just loving it.